F. Scott Fitzgerald said there are no second acts in American lives, but he never met Mark Sanford, who seems to be bent on trying to prove Fitzgerald wrong. As you're about to see, the governor has already begun to live out his own second act. Politicians often don't like to talk about their flaws, but the governor recently sat down with me. I apologize. I had to run out here, folks. And he talked eagerly about forgiveness, legacy, and looking back.
House will come to order.
For a time, he turned South Carolina's House of State into perhaps the most famous confessional in the world.
I've been unfaithful to my wife.
At Capitol Rotunda, admission of infidelity with an Argentine woman launched Mark Sanford into a media storm.
Don't cry for me, Argentina.
Don't cry for me, Argentina. Boy, it's...
Yet these months later, he's found his way to a state of calm.
I guess, simply encapsulate it in the larger word called grace. I probably learned more about both God's grace and the grace of people in this state in this last chapter of my life than I have over the whole of my life.
And there'll be generation upon generation that will be here working in this plant.
The chapter since the scandal, the state, in a team effort, landed Boeing and watched the governor's numbers lift off. A Rasmussen poll recently measured his approval at 55%. Serious afterlife for a man who admits he stood on the brink of resigning.
Inches away.
The governor says the people helped to pull him back from that brink with how they forgave him.
For anybody who has failed in any walk of life, in any sense of life, is to accept the forgiveness of others, to accept God's forgiveness, and frankly, to forgive oneself.
And during our time together here, the governor chose to keep most of his private life private. He wouldn't talk about the woman he had called his soulmate, any future they may have together. But he did open up some about his now ex-wife, Jenny.
As I explained in the book, I looked at it as honest. I mean, you know, Mark's a very kind of a, you know, he's a gentle guy, but he's actually fairly honest. I mean, until this last year, but...
Her autobiography, Staying True, lifted the Sanford affair even higher into the national media orbit.
You know, there's nobody cheaper than this guy. I mean, this guy can, you know, pinch a penny.
Governor, this rotunda's got a whole lot of memories for you, good and bad.
Yet in that rotunda, where the infamous confession happened, the governor talked openly about their relationship today.
What's the state of your relationship with Jenny right now?
It's good. It's cordial.
Friendship?
Yeah. We're friends, and we share four fabulous boys whose lives we're both pouring into. Mm-hmm.
There in the office, the governor keeps pictures of himself and the boys with Jenny on high display, a sense of family. Clearly surviving the marriage.
They're great young men, and they're continuing to develop, and we're both very, very proud of them.
Right. Professionally, Mark Sanford is proud of how he watched a dollar. His love of small government, with spending as thin as Franklin's hair, have bought him a reputation he still enjoys.
We were absolutely focused on the money issue. So you saw the largest recurring tax cut, the first cut to the marginal income tax, a lot of food fights on spending. And it was really all about a much larger proxy, which is money is a proxy for freedom.
And there's freedom from long lines at the DMV. The governor points to that as but one sign of how his administration changed how Columbia affects South Carolinians.
For instance, I think this year I'm guardedly optimistic that there will be a change to the Budget Control Board. But it wouldn't have happened without 8 years of tug-of-war and a whole lot of fussing and fighting.
But how the governor chose to fight caused a fair amount of fuss in itself. He carried pigs into the State House, symbols of the pork barrel deficit spending he despises.
I think pork won and the taxpayers lost.
Look, the whole pig thing, I don't like using a political tool that's that blunt. But when I'm left with no other choice, I absolutely will. And in that instance... it served its purpose.
Serving a high purpose is how Mark Sanford sees the Tea Party,
USA!
Whose gospel he has preached for years.
Our country was founded on this notion of people taking things into their own hands.
Here's our new governor, Nikki Haley.
He believes Governor-elect Nikki Haley will also buck the political system and have the same fight on her hands, but he clearly sees an army of support out there at what he deems a history-making time.
You know, we had a 1776 moment. Are we at Alamo moment? Are we at a Pearl Harbor, a D-Day moment? I think we're at a big, big moment in American history.
There's no telling whether he'll try to write himself into political history again.
The
New York Times recently quoted the governor as saying, nothing is impossible. With us, he was fairly coy about the future, political or otherwise.
I don't know what all that means. I suspect what it means is business, and I suspect what it means is heading back down toward the coast, but we'll see.
In Mark Sanford, those State House grounds saw a governor forge a legacy of conservative ideas.
Do solemnly swear.
With a liberal helping of recovery from scandal.
There are a whole host of different temptations in life, but one of them is to look backward and to dwell on that which you cannot change.
He will soon walk away, claiming to carry what he's learned.
You can have genuine regret. You can make mistakes in life. But the key is picking up, and if you're still breathing, God ain't through with you yet.
You heard him mention there, the governor said he's headed down to the coast when he's done, but he also confided that as of last Friday, he had not made any permanent living arrangements at all. One more thing here. During the Monica Lewinsky scandal, then-Congressman Mark Sanford voted for impeachment of President Bill Clinton. Now on the heels of his own affair, lying about where he was, the ethics charges for which he paid fines, I asked the governor if he would make that same vote again. He answered by acknowledging his own moral deficiency, his words, and he said his impeachment vote was a matter of whether the president had told the truth about the Lewinsky affair. He concluded his answer with this, quote, I'll just say I've learned a lot about grace. To see the governor's entire answer on that and for more of my one-on-one with Governor Mark Sanford, just go to WYFF4.com.